Hello YouTube and welcome to a short tax loss video. I've tested now the external Samsung SSD, the T3 with 2 terabytes of storage for exactly 1 year. Last year, close before the IFA in Germany, Samsung contacted me and asked, hey, do you want to check out our new Samsung SSD line? And I said, yes. So they sent me this and they got some trouble, but now for over a year, I used this device. And what should I say? I loved it from the first moment, because normally I've carried it around and used external 2.5-inch normal external drives. Okay, these are now from WD or Western Digital, my favorite brand. I'm not usually, if I'm buying drives, I'm not really that into Samsung, but I really have to say, in terms of SSDs, I'm definitely Samsung fanboy at the moment. I don't have to tell you, if you're carrying your external drives around with you, then from first sight, you can see some difference here. This device takes up way less storage and space in your backpack, in your pockets, or everywhere you carry it around than this. The second thing, it's way lighter. This weighs nearly to nothing. You won't notice that you're carrying this device around with you. This weighs something. Then the third thing, here it's a normal HDD. We got rotational parts, we got mechanical parts. I know, normally, if you're not using it, those parts are locked, but still, this is something I know. I carried around years and years and years. I carried those devices around, never had a problem with it, but just from the feeling of carrying it around, that I got here moving parts and here I don't, this gives me slight better feeling. Then next thing, you all know it from your normal devices. HDD compared to SSDs in terms of speed, this is way faster. So this is something you get only advantages if you're willing to pay a higher price. Price is the problem here. The same storage from an old HDD costs maybe 3, 4, 5 times as much. This is why, or another reason, just to show you that I'm willing to pay this price. This is one of the gadgets that's changed my, not life, but my hardware equipment life. I would never ever go back to a normal HDD, external HDD, after having an external SSD. This is why I bought myself SSD from Western Digital with 512 gigabytes in storage, and the successor to the T3, the T5 from Samsung with 1 terabyte of storage. I was able to buy this for 200 euros or less than 200 euros at Amazon Italy. And those are the things I will now use privately, bought from my own money, just to give you the hint. But this is something I'm willing to pay extra the money, 3, 4, 5 times the money for a way thinner device with faster performance and not having constantly the fear that maybe it will break when it falls down or anything like that. So this is it. Oh, and one thing, another disadvantage, but of course, it's USB Type-C. It's USB 3.1 on data transfer rates. Yes, but the T3's got the problem, not really a problem, but they only come with this USB Type-C to Type-A to a normal USB cable within. So you don't get another USB C to USB Type-C cable or an adapter. No, you have to get this for yourself. If you're, for example, using the new MacBook Pros from Apple with Thunderbolt 3 ports or the Dell XPS line from 2018, or this is the thing they changed with the T5 line. Of course, the T5 should also be a little bit faster, not much. This is not the big advantage here. But it comes also with a USB Type-C to USB Type-C cable and also with a USB Type-C to USB Type-A cable. But these are things, and even if you have to pay extra money for the Samsung SSDs or if Western Digital SSDs are, or external SSDs are just exactly as nice to have as the Samsung SSDs. This is something I will figure out in the next couple of weeks, months or years. But this is it. Thank you guys for watching and I see you all in the next video. Bye!